The formula you're using, I'll just say this right now, is actually, the formula that you're using in that problem is a little different. And I'll put off, but you take it for granted, it's actually a formula for how to produce these statements. That formula comes from an E=mc² argument, which also gives you, this effect. And there you talk about light being emitted, and then you say it has a certain energy. You then have to figure out what's the energy of light. We're going to get to that end of next week. That's going to start a quantum mechanics. That energy is proportional to frequency of something called a Planck's constant. And because the energy is proportional to frequency, and then energy you can talk about being essentially an M and an E=mc², you can work that around and see how much the frequency has to change if something has gone through the energy throughout this paper. So anyway, so a slightly different argument is you could give you a formula you're using in that problem. Okay? All right, a lot of talking, but I just want to get you sort of mentally ready for these. The problems are not too hard, but they will be harder ones next week. Okay? Kyle, is that everything? Is pretty much covered?
Thanks. Carl Ludwig.